Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Simplifying Business Studies. Myself Kashish Talwani welcomes you back again to my channel, where today I am bringing very important chapter of your syllabus, which is chapter number 6. After planning and organizing, this is the third function of management, which we are going to understand in detail in this chapter. So just to brief you about what we will do in this chapter, let me just make you understand, give you a glimpse of what we will understand in this chapter. So yes, it is very important for an organization to have plans, and it is very important for an organization to have a suitable organizational structure. But it is even more important to fill this structure with the right kind of people. An organization can make optimum use of all the available resources, whether they are financial resources or whether they are physical resources, only through competent human resource. So hardworking and efficient people are the principal or most important asset of any organization. The key to the success of any organization is having right person at the right job, and this is what staffing means. So we are going to understand all and each and everything about staffing in this chapter. So this is the content of this chapter. We will understand the concept of staffing. We will understand the importance of staffing. We will understand what is staffing process, and we will understand the different sources of recruitment. We will include internal and external resources, and we will also understand merits and demerits of both these different sources. We will understand the process of selection and also what is training and development. So in this particular session, we will understand the concept of staffing, that means its meaning, its definitions, and also we will understand the importance of this function of management. So let's quickly start our lesson. So yes, as I just told you that organizational structure is important, but it is even more important to fill it with right kind of people. So definitely the key to the success of any organization lies in the hands of people in the organization. That means if we fill all the positions in an organization with the right people, we can have all the goals achieved as we have expected. So if these right kind of people are not put at the right job, the organization would not be able to achieve its objectives. The growth and the prosperity of the organization requires continual infusion of quality staff. So this is a continuous process. People may come, people may leave, but it's the responsibility of the organization to keep all the positions filled for the longest period of time with the best and the most competent personnel for the organization. Thus, appropriate human resource is essential for success of any organization. Filling the positions and retaining the right and the competent people is the focus of staffing function of management. Let's see what we have on our screen. Once the organizational goals are set up and plans are prepared, the organization is appropriately structured to pave the path for achieving of the set goals. All the resources like materials, machines, equipments are useless without competent personnel. Personnel means staff, the people who work in an organization. So each organization must have competent and skillful personnel to fill various job positions created through the organizational structure. I hope you understood what I'm trying to bring to your notice, like what staffing is, and it's quite enough to have introduction of staffing this way. So let's now understand the concept, the meaning, or the definition of staffing. The process of putting people to jobs is termed as staffing. Absolutely, when we put the right people at a job, it is called staffing. Staffing is defined as a managerial function of filling and keeping filled the position in the organizational structure with qualified and competent staff. So yes, filling those positions and keeping them filled is another aspect of staffing function. Staffing is the management function that involves hiring of candidates suitable for an organization by evaluating their skills, knowledge, and offering specific roles as per their skill set. It is involved in fulfillment of human resource requirement for an organization. So staffing is not a process which is, you know, just done by, you know, trial and error, or, you know, just by the will of the managers. It's a whole process which needs lot of consideration, lot of cautiousness, and yes, everyone who comes across for this recruitment or selection process, their skills are evaluated and their knowledge is assessed, and then certain specific roles as per their skill set are given to those people. If we will not be able to, you know, put the right person at the right job, definitely there will be lot of things at stake. There will be wastage of resources, there will be, you know, lesser efficiency on their part, and there may not be the achievement of goals as they are set for the organization. So now we will understand all the points of importance of staffing. The first point is obtaining competent personnel. So yes, staffing function is required to fill various job positions in an organization. There will be no use of job positions unless and until they are occupied by the competent employees. So staffing helps in discovering and obtaining these competent people for the right jobs. For example, your school principal identifies the departments which are short of teachers and work towards finding out the required personnel, required teachers for the organization. So yes, proper staffing helps in discovering and obtaining competent personnel for various jobs. Next point is high performance. So staffing ensures higher performance by putting right person at the right job. For example, in order to get best results, teachers who are proficient in business studies are the right people to be appointed in the commerce department to teach this particular subject. If we will put a teacher who has experience in physics to teach business studies, definitely that will be a blunder for the organization and for the students as well. So higher performance can only be expected out of people when they are put at the right place with the required skill set that is required to, you know, comply with that particular job. So proper staffing ensures higher performance by putting the right person on the right job. Next point is continuous growth. An organization definitely grows with the efforts of employees. It doesn't grow with only the plans and the structure, and it only grows when all these things are done properly by the right people. So by appointing competent and efficient employees, staffing ensures continuous survival and growth of the organization. This kind of staff enables an organization to function successfully in this kind of ever-changing environment. So yes, proper staffing ensures continuous survival and growth of an enterprise. Next point is optimum utilization of human resources. Proper staffing enables the organization to acquire required quality and required quantity of the employees in maybe different departments in an organization. As a result, this staffing process facilitates optimum utilization of human resource by avoiding overstaffing and prevents disruption or stoppage of work by indicating in advance about what likely the shortage of employee that may arise in an organization. So it prevents underutilization of personnel and high labor cost. So an organization which is able to judge what is the right number of people, what is the right quality of people are needed in an organization, they can definitely prevent, wastage of human resource and definitely higher labor cost. Last point under this category is improves job satisfaction. So through this objective, objective assessment and by giving fair rewards to the employees for their contribution in an organization, staffing improves job satisfaction and it improves the morale of the employees. For example, let's suppose at the end of one academic year, school may plan appraisal for teachers to give, you know, a teacher of the year kind of award. So this brings satisfaction to the teacher who has worked hard and also motivates others to work harder. So this kind of thing can be observed in your school, and you know, people can be promoted to, you know, inculcate this kind of feeling among them. So all these things improve job satisfaction and morale of the employees, and definitely that benefits the organization in a very long run. So children, I hope you all understood what I try to make you all understand. I hope you all liked my video. If you actually liked it, do not forget to like it and do leave a comment in the comment box. Hope you all have a good day ahead. Thank you very much.